Hi friends, in today's video we're going to fly to France and read a book called Crepes by Suzette. It is morning and Suzette is making a big batch of batter. She's getting ready to make her special kind of pancakes. It is called crepes in French. She cooks and sells them ready to eat from her street cart, which she takes all over the city of Paris. Close to home, Suzette goes to her neighborhood market to choose the best fresh fruits for her crepes. Finally, her cart is loaded with everything she needs for the day. Now she is ready for customers. On y va! Suzette's friend, the postman, greets her. Bonjour! He stops for a chat and a morning treat. She will make him a tasty hot crepe filled with fresh raspberry, his favorite. He is the first customer of the day. Suzette pushes her cart into the park. The people sitting on the grass are happy to see her. She offers many different types of crepes, and it's hard for them to choose. They decide on crepes filled with fruit jams. S'il vous plaît. A child has just fallen down and his mother is comforting him. How about a crepe with banana? Oui. Suzette pours the creamy batter onto a hot griddle and smooths it out into a thin, perfectly round pancake. The boy feels much better already. As Suzette pushes her cart along the river, she meets street musicians filling the air with fast, jazzy sounds. They signal her over and call out what they want. The first crepe sizzles and edges turn crispy golden brown. Ooh la la. Outside the museum, an artist is working on a portrait. He is ready to take a break and just wants a snack. At the right moment, Suzette flips the crepe over with her long spatula. Close by come the laughter and chatter of children. Just dismissed from school, they all want crepes filled with chocolate. C'est bon! A fancy lady out shopping craves something sweet. The mouth-watering smell rises up from the cart and tempts her. Suzette folds the crepe neatly in half, then sprinkles it with sugar. Voila! A dancer is on her way to the theater for a rehearsal of tonight's ballet performance. Would she like a zesty lemon crepe to give her an extra burst of energy? Oui, bien sûr. Suzette has many customers by the carousel. She quickly cooks one crepe after another. She spreads them with delicious filling and folds them into triangles to hand out.
That makes a crepe for her last customers, the honeymooners, to share. She hands it to them wrapped in a paper, warm and sweet. They thank her together. Merci beaucoup. By the end of the day, Suzette is tired. She has so many customers. After so much hard work, it is time to go home. But she will be back with her street cart and more delicious crepes tomorrow. Au revoir!
Now we're going to move on to our crepe recipe. So you're going to grab 2 eggs, 1 cup of milk, 1 cup of flour, 1 tablespoon of melted butter, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and 1/4 teaspoon of salt. You're also going to grab your fruit of choice. So as we have here, we got strawberries and bananas we're going to fill our crepes with. We're gonna start off by measuring out 1 cup of flour and pouring that into the bowl. This is a good activity to do at home with your children. They can be helping you measuring out the different ingredients and even whisking in all the ingredients. Now that we've measured out our flour, we're going to measure out 1 cup of milk as well, and you can just put it off to the side. If you do not want to use milk, you can use any milk substitute of your choice, or just even substitute with water instead. Now that we've measured out all our ingredients, in a large bowl you're going to use 1 cup of flour and crack in 2 eggs. So once you've mixed in your egg and flour like this consistency, this is when you can start incorporating the milk. So you're going to pour the milk slowly a bit at a time until it gets to a smooth consistency. So we're going to add the milk slowly at a time, as you can see I'm doing here. As well, I'm also going to add in some vanilla extract. This is optional. I like to have that vanilla scent in my crepes when I'm making it. So that's why I decided to add it. This is completely optional. If you do not want to add it in, you don't have to. You can just skip this step. Again, we're going to keep mixing and just seeing how the batter is doing. In my case, I thought my batter was a little too thin for my liking, so I added some more flour, just a little bit, to kind of thicken it up. It is also up to you. If you wanted a thinner batter, you can just, you know, always add more milk. If you want it to be a little on the thicker side, you can just add a little flour, just like I did here. So in this clip, I've decided to grab a bowl because I'm going to strain my batter. Straining my batter just makes sure that there's no extra flour clumps in the crepe batter that I've mixed. I just do this a few times to make sure, you know, all the flour has been incorporated and has been broken down. That way when I am making my batter or when I'm making the crepes, there's no clumps, and that makes sure it makes sure that the crepe is cooking evenly. Thank you. Now that I've strained my batter a few times and making sure it's the consistency I want it to be, we're going to use some cling wrap to, you know, wrap the bowl and put it in the fridge. I'm going to put it in the fridge for about 30 minutes. That way it can, the ingredients can incorporate. And just before I'm about to make the crepes, we're going to take it out maybe 5 minutes before we get started. Once I put all the ingredients in back in the fridge, I'm just going to wipe down the counters and start prepping and cutting the ingredients. So I like to clean in between when I'm cooking. That way there's less of a mess to clean up when I'm completely done. For today's crepes, I decided to just use strawberry and banana. So we're going to start off by cutting them into small coin pieces. As I mentioned earlier, you guys can use any fruits of your choice. You can always add in different ones, but for my crepes, I'm just using strawberry and banana. You can always use mixed berries like raspberries, strawberries, sometimes even mango, peaches, anything you want. As you can see here, I'm just about done cutting up my pieces, so we got a lot of strawberries and a lot of bananas. Now we're going to start cooking our crepes. Like I mentioned, just before cooking your crepes, just take it out 5 minutes for the batter to chill out. So we're going to start off by heating our pan at maximum level. It's going to take about a minute or so for the pan to heat up. Once the pan is heated up, we're going to add some butter to cook the crepes. If you do not want to use butter, you can just substitute using just regular cooking oil or even cooking spray. So we're just going to add a bit of crepes to kind of spread it all over the pan. So once we've added the butter, we're going to now scoop in about 2 scoops of batter. Because we don't have the thingy that makes the crepes, we're just going to use a pan to kind of spread it all out evenly and just kind of make sure there's no, all the spots are covered. So as you can see, I'm just turning around to make sure, you know, all the batter has been mixed in. And then we're going to just turn it to the 8 fire. That way the crepe doesn't burn. If you want, you can just blow it to even medium. It's up to you. For me, I like my crepes a little crispy. So you can see here, I left it at level 8. But if you don't want it to be this crispy, you can just turn it down. For the crepes, you're just going to cook it for 2 to 3 minutes on each side and they should be ready. So as you can see, I'm just adding butter again because we're going to continue cooking our crepe batter until we have no more batter. If you want, you can even just cook about however much crepes you want, and you can just leave in the batter. The batter is good in the fridge for up to 3 days, so you can just make sure to keep it in the fridge. And before you cook it, just mix the batter to kind of make sure all the ingredients are incorporated. Now it's time to start assembling our crepes. So I'm gonna put a crepe on the plate and start off by adding in some bananas. After adding in some bananas, I'm gonna lay some strawberries on top of it. Again, this part you can add any fruit of your choice. It is completely up to you. You can just add in other fruits you have. And then the first method we're going to use to wrap up our crepes is the burrito method. So you're going to fold two sides and then just wrap it until you get to the end. And here you have a burrito looking crepe. So next up, we have the triangle method. So we're going to start off by laying our ingredients in one corner of the crepe. So here I'm just laying all my strawberries that I want in my crepes. So you're not supposed to fold in half. I made a mistake here, but you're going to see that I'm going to unfold the crepe later on. So we're going to add in all the strawberries we want. Yep, so we're gonna just put everything in one ingredients, fold in half, and then fold another half, and there we have it. So there we have it, we've assembled both our crepes. Let me know what fruits you decide to put on your crepes. Time to dig in!